I'm Lala. This is Flavors of New York. We are on West 26th Street for the opening of a new cocktail bar called the Ivory Peacock. We're also getting to interview like 8 authors on the books that they've written about food and cocktails and the industry in general. I couldn't be more excited. Let's get to this. All of these drinks sound amazing. I am a tequila and a mezcal girl, so I think I'm gonna go with the patio pounder. It has tequila, it has mezcal, it's got some mandarin and tangerine mix, and then some bitters. I'm sure it's gonna be delicious. Have been so epically delicious. I'm very excited to see what they do here. I do know that they have a raw bar in the back, and I'm a happy girl whenever there's oysters. I'm here with Aleksandra Crapanzano. She is a dessert columnist.
For the Wall Street Journal.
For the Wall Street Journal. That's quite the credential.
Thank you.
And we're here tonight because you have authored this book.
I have authored a book called Gâteau.
Let's show it to them.
Oh my goodness, here it is. Here's my book. Third book, but I grew up in France. And I wanted to write a book about the cakes that the French really do bake.
And gâteau is obviously the French word for cake.
Exactly. So
exactly. Tell us about the recipes in your book.
They are super simple. They're the ones that you do not buy at patisseries. They are the ones that you really do bake at home, that my friends bake at home, that I grew up eating at home. Yogurt cakes, nut cakes, a little bit of Genoise, a lot of boozy cakes, a lot of soaking syrups. I mean, here we are at a bar.
Right.
A lot of boozy cakes. Some bûche de Noël for Christmas.
Okay, so what you're saying is
a lot of chocolate.
Even the novice baker
absolutely
can follow this.
There are recipes in here that literally are taught in nursery school.
Oh, wow.
Yes, they're like our Toll House cookies, right? They make a yogurt cake in kindergarten that is on the curriculum. Everybody makes it. It's amazing.
How very French.
It's very
so
French.
It's French, but not fancy.
It's French, but not fancy.
I love this.
Exactly. Ten minutes to get into the oven.
Amazing. And this book is available where?
Everywhere. Published by Scribner.
Is available everywhere. Do you hear that? Go get Gâteau. It sounds like it would be a beautiful gift to give for the holidays.
Perfect gift.
Thank you for chatting with me.
Thank you.
You're welcome. I'm here with the author of American Rye, Clay Risen.
Hey there.
So I take it that you are a rye expert.
I am now. I've had a lot of rye, so okay. I guess that makes me an expert, yeah.
And tell me about this book.
So it's history, it's how rye is made, it's reviews and profiles of hundreds of rye whiskeys, and hopefully people who like the category, are interested in the category, will pick it up and learn something and take it to their liquor store and make better choices about their rye whiskey.
Do you have a favorite rye?
I do.
Well, we're not allowed to say on camera.
Do I have a favorite? I have lots of favorites. There are some delicious.
What about tips for people who don't know enough or don't know a lot about rye but want to go purchase one? What would you tell them?
So I would say, first of all, don't be afraid of rye. Okay. Everyone says, it's so spicy. It's not spicy. It's like, it's more like baking spicy, you know?
Yeah.
It's that sort of stuff. And then to try a variety. There's so many different kinds out there. Try a young rye. It's going to be herbal and floral and grassy and agricultural. And an older rye, it's got chocolate and mint and barrel and totally different. And so I would say, you know, try a bunch of those and see where you land.
I love that. And does this book give different flavor profiles?
It does.
Different cocktail recipes?
No, there no cocktail recipes.
Okay.
I will leave that to
just neat? We're just drinking it neat?
Just drinking it neat.
Okay.
And then I leave it to you to figure out what works what.
I love
where.
That. And where can people get this book?
They can get it at wherever fine books are sold.
Wherever
they can get it on Amazon. They can get it, wherever books are sold these days.
Right. I have to say, I love the feel of this book.
Thank you.
And I just love the way that it looks. It's beautiful, the green and the gold. It's stunning.
Thanks.
Congratulations.
Right.
Thank you for chatting with me.
All right.
All right, next comes these two. This is Steven. This is Aaron. And they wrote this book. Brand Mysticism, Cultivating Creativity. Just tell me about this book.
So I'm Stephen Grasse, and the book's about my adventures creating many spirits brands like Hendrick's Gin, Sailor Jerry Rum, and me and Aaron met because he wrote an article about how to make a booze brand go viral for Vine Pear, and we had such a good time working on the article that we decided to make it a whole book.
Well, that's amazing because that's the goal right now. Everybody just wants to go viral, right?
Yes.
Absolutely. No matter the space, and you know, I don't think a lot of people think a booze brand can go viral. Steven's the master of it, and this is his distilled wisdom in a book.
So you're the tech guy more so, and you're the cocktail guy, and you're bringing the two together? Is that somewhat correct?
This is his story.
Okay.
I'm just the guy who typed it out.
he distilled it out of me.
Yeah.
So if you could tell any of these fine people that are watching this a very important takeaway from this book, give me some words of wisdom. Give me something.
You need to keep things weird. You
yeah.
need to
like that.
Ignore research. Don't enter award shows. Don't look at social media. What you should do is read old books and keep things weird.
Love that advice. Mm. That's kind of like the antithesis of what you would think, but I'm super down with that. You want to throw anything into there?
Trendiness is the worst thing you can be. Hendrick's Gin was created not to be trendy,
right?
And it still exists today, and it's still stocked at this bar with 800 gins.
Yeah, because trends come and go, and we're looking for like longevity.
Greatness
correct?
Stays forever. Yeah. Absolutely.
Awesome. Where can people purchase this book?
Anywhere finer books are sold.
I love it. Check it out, everyone. Thank you for chatting with me.
Thank you.
I am here with author Philip Greene. Hello.
Hello.
And this is your book, Cheers, Cocktails and Toasts to Celebrate Every Day of the Year. Tell me about this book.
So it's based on the premise that everybody likes a good story, everybody likes a good drink, they like to feel like, let's celebrate something, what are we going to drink? So you open up to today's date, and let's say it's January 23rd, and you say, all right, well, what are we drinking to? What are we celebrating? Well, on this day in 1943, the movie Casablanca debuted. What a great movie, one of the greatest films of all time. The love story of Rick and Ilsa in war-torn Casablanca. Okay, well, what are we drinking? We're drinking the French 75, because it was featured in the movie. There's a scene where Yvonne, a French girl, is going out on a date with a German officer, which is not a good idea, but she wants to have French 75s lined up from here to here, maybe because she needs to get drunk to go out with a German officer. I don't know. Okay, well, what's our toast? We have to have an event we're celebrating, a drink, a toast, and a song to listen to. So what's the toast? Here's Looking at You, Kid, the classic toast from Casablanca. And what song? You must remember this.
I love kiss that just, tie-in.
So
oh, that song.
Every day has those four elements. Something we're celebrating, a drink connected to it in some way, a toast or a quote, and a song or a video to watch.
What
and
a fun concept.
It's a
so
lot
I'm just going to randomly flip this open to a date,
okay.
All right?
All right.
Oh, my God. I just opened this book to my
your birthday.
I'm not even kidding. Oh my God, this is so crazy.
You're pretty good.
April 18th, the midnight. So we've got a
so
variation
the
on the Manhattan. Okay.
So that was the midnight ride of Paul Revere.
1775. We have the event, then we have the cocktail, we have the recipe. I love this. And then it gives me a mood. It says, listen to Kicks by Paul Revere and the Raiders, or The British Are Coming by Weezer.
Yeah.
I love Weezer.
Yeah, so every day has those four elements, and it's a lot of fun. I mean, people sometimes need, like, what are we celebrating? Oh, gosh, well, I got a promotion today, or, you know, obviously something like that. But sometimes it could be just something random and fun, like, you know, the episode where Jim and Pam get married in the office is one of them.
Is that in here?
Or something from Hamilton, or sometimes it's I Love Lucy or The Honeymooners, something from my generation, but sometimes I tried to keep it. I didn't want it to sound like something, you know, like a 50-something-year-old white guy writing a book. So I tried to have a very diverse and inclusive, you know, content in it. So
well,
it's a lot of fun writing.
It sounds like a lot of fun.
It's a lot of fun.
It also sounds like the perfect gift.
And
since the holidays are coming, buy this gift for people. This book will be available at Anthropology.
Yep.
Cheers. This is author Jordan Hughes. So you have written a book called Twist.
Yes.
Unfortunately, we don't have the actual hard copy of it, so I need you to tell me about it. What is Twist?
Yeah, so it's a cocktail recipe book. I am actually a commercial beverage photographer by day, so it's very image-focused, so a lot of beautiful photos of cocktails, as well as tons of recipes. It's very geared for kind of your at-home consumer, your cocktail enthusiast, to learn how to make their own home bar, and not just how to make cocktails, there's tons of recipes, but it's also just how to come up with your own cocktails. So using classic drinks, drinks like the Old Fashioned, the Daiquiri, to use those as kind of jumping off points for recipe creation.
And you're a photographer as well. So
yeah.
I bet the did you do the photography?
So I did all the photos myself.
Well?
Yeah. So wrote Amazing. It, photographed it, all of that.
Okay. And these are some cards from the book. So we have some things to look at.
Yeah. So I have some images from the book. So these were just little recipe cards to give out. Have some of the recipes, some of the photos.
This looks beautiful.
Thank you. Yeah.
Love that ice. So, stunning.
Yeah. So just tried to do, you know, I've been shooting drinks and working for liquor brands for years now. So. Try to just create, you know, the best images I possibly could, sort of thing, for this book. So I think I did it. I think it's some of my best work.
You think you nailed it?
Amazing.
So. Yeah. So for the cocktail enthusiast in your life, go check out Jordan's book called Twist.
Brian
Freedman. And he wrote a book called Crushed, How a Changing Climate is Altering the Way We Drink. So Brian, how is a changing climate altering the way we drink?
I mean, it's changing how vineyards grow grapes. Mm-hmm. How the farmers grow the grains for our spirits. It's changing how harvesting happens. Everything is being shifted with wine, at least sort of earlier, right? As things are getting warmer, grapes are getting riper much more quickly. Everything is changing, and producers across the spectrum have to make these very hard decisions, vintage after vintage. The good news is that from reporting for this book, and I take 8 regions around the world, and I tell the stories of the producers who are living through these dramatic changes, I think that these are gonna be the people who help lead us into the future. They're gonna teach us how to pivot and how to find a way to survive in this changing climate.
So you're gonna learn a lot about alcohol, but you're also gonna learn about being more socially conscious, perhaps.
Yes.
And if there are people that care, as everyone should, about climate change and booze,
yes,
they will love
absolutely.
This book.
Yes.
And I love that take. I feel like it's really, I feel like that hasn't ever been done before.
Not, there hasn't been a book written that's story driven for consumers. And we all love this amazing liquid in our glass, right? Like
yes,
we're sort of hiding our cocktails here. But that's, you know, these things are being affected by climate change. We should want to know how, so that we can, when we buy bottles, support the producers who are doing the right things. And it really, climate change has its tentacles in lots of areas we wouldn't expect, and that's what I wanted to report
on
here.
Absolutely. And we should be concerned, and we should be aware of this. So, if you're curious, check out this book. Ryan's book, it's called Crushed. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
You're welcome. I am here with Amanda Schuster. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
You wrote a book. And
I did.
It is called Drink Like a Local, A Field Guide to New York's Best Bars. Okay, I need this book. Also, I want your job because you got to just run around to bars checking them out and then writing about them. Tell me about this.
So I was commissioned to do this. My first book was New York Cocktails, and it came out in 2017, and they wanted something that had more of a, you know, things that weren't necessarily cocktail bars. There are quite a few in there, but we really wanted to talk about the places where real New Yorkers go.
I love that. And I noticed, flipping through it, you have it laid out by neighborhood?
Yeah.
Amazing. And tell me about researching and running around. Like, what made the cut?
The book, I began writing it in 2019.
Okay, and then,
so it was supposed to come out in, it was supposed to finish by March of 2020, and then Mother Nature
That's
had
weird.
Other
I wonder
ideas.
What happened.
Yeah, I know. So things understandably got put on hold. And so really my process was, I had done a lot of the research before then, and I was really thinking to myself, I wanted to really discuss underrepresented bars. Bars that, you know, weren't always in top 50 lists.
Yeah.
You know, not the bars that always got featured in the New York Times or other, you know, really big publications. And to really, you know, really show people how New Yorkers, what makes a local in New York? And is it even necessarily the bar that's near your house?
Right. So quick question, and you don't have to answer this if you don't want to show favoritism. But if somebody's coming to visit New York and they have 24 hours,
oh, wow.
What is the bar or just one that pops into your head that you have to go to?
Keene's.
I love Keene's. It's a steakhouse.
I don't even have to think about that.
It's one of the oldest steakhouses in New York City, but the bar is also amazing. They have like the pipes, like Teddy Roosevelt's old pipes. And why are you picking that? I love that choice, but tell me why.
Because it's so quintessentially New York.
Yes.
If you're only going to be in New York for 24 hours, go to a real New York bar.
Agreed.
Something that's been here for a long time. Something where, you know, a place where real New Yorkers go. And also people who are not necessarily from New York. You know, it's this great cross culture of the city, where it's some tourists who just really want to go to a great steakhouse, and then people who are really from New York who sit at the bar all the time.
What a great choice. I love that. Thank you so much for chatting. Go get Thank Amanda's you. Book, Drink Like a Local New York, and drink your way through the city. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
You're welcome. I'm here with Michael Anstendig, and he has written this book, Art of the Japanese Cocktail. The cover's stunning. The ice, Japanese do the ice so well. I remember watching a Japanese cocktail maker make the diamond ice. What an amazing process. Will you tell me about this book?
Yeah, the book is a labor of love. It tells the story of Masahiro Urushito, who's the head bartender of Katana Kitten. And he really created
Great West Village bar.
A great West Village bar that is an actual Japanese-American bar. It's a hybrid of the two drinking cultures and the best of both worlds. And he's really popularized Japanese drinking traditions and culture in the U.S. So to work with him was truly an honor.
I love that. I mean, that bar gets written up. It's very well known. It's won a bunch of awards. And I assume there's a whole highball section in here.
There's an incredible highball section.
I love it. So thank you for chatting with us. Where can people get this book?
They can get it at Amazon or their favorite independent bookstore.
I love that. Thank you so much, Michael, for chatting.
Thank you.
This book is beautiful. I'm excited to read it.
Thank you.
Tonight was epic. I had amazing cocktails, some really yummy appetizers, and I talked to so many authors. If you like books as much as I do, the holiday's coming up. There's so many books I want to get my hands on. Definitely make sure you check out all of them. And check out the Ivory Peacock for flavors of New York. I'm Lala.
Bye.